I will be very brief so that we don't miss a point. Very, very brief. So, time. So that nobody may go hungry. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. It is clear that the main theme of these masses readings is not the Eucharist. Get that right. The problem of physical or material bread is closely associated, or if you like, closely linked to the celebration of the Eucharist. But may I draw your attention to the fact that those who announce the word today run the risk of insisting too much on the miraculous aspect of the episode presented in the first and gospel readings, and losing sight of the more important message. And that message, I want all of us to get it. And that is, the bread belonging to one must be not for all. Or otherwise, the bread for one is bread for all. That is it. Points for our meditation. Three small points so that you capture it. As disciples of Christ, or call it as Christians, we must or we cannot break bread together unless we share with our brothers and sisters the material bread. Give it to them. Don't have an argument. Oh, it would not be enough. It's small. Give it to them. Those words coming from the first reading, even the gospel, give it to them. Don't mind how big or small. Second point, we can have a new society or a new world only when we renounce our selfishness and accept Jesus' proposal of establishing the idea of sharing one's material goods. Many people heard that. When you are asked, share this to this. No, no, no. It should be for me. For me. Selfishness. The third point links with this small second reading. It is only in this way we can unite as one body in Christ. Amen.